Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to, well, whatever I'm going to end up calling this series, I suppose. I don't really have a clue. I suppose I should call it something. But, yeah, here we are. Welcome back to Eurotruck Simulator 2. Series as yet untitled, I guess. We did a video of this the other day. I filed it under the name of Now for Something Completely Different, which is what I tend to do at the moment for games which are a bit different from what I normally do, just to see if people are interested. And the general response was interesting, for both in terms of view count. I don't expect it'll stay that way, but I actually got more views on the Eurotruck video I did than I did on the latest Fallout New Vegas video, which blew my mind slightly. I didn't think it would be that way at all. And in terms of the comments, the overall general sort of common trend seemed to be me saying, oh guys, you're probably all going to find this really, really boring and you're probably not going to like it and whatever, but I think it's fun, so I'm sharing it with you. And then you guys responding by saying, we all love this game. We've been playing this for years. We think it's awesome. We're glad you're actually doing a video of it now. And I'm like, oh, okay, fine. All right then. Well, there you go. There's me failing to, I guess underestimating the audience, I suppose. So there you go. I figured you'd all think that this was extremely boring, wouldn't be interested anymore. And yet, the response was overwhelmingly positive, so I guess I better shut up and play the game, huh? Alright, so. Let's see. I'm picking up exactly where we left off last time. We arrived in Chelmsford, did our garlic delivery. And now we're back on the main screen here. And because we don't own a truck of our own, we could purchase one, but we don't have enough money. Nowhere near enough money at all. So instead, what we need to go do is go to the job market and find a quick job where we get hired as a contractor or whatever, and we get given a rental truck, and we go deliver some cargo somewhere for that. So let's go ahead and look at Cambridge, which is where we're based out of currently, and see what's available. You can sort all these jobs here by price per distance, price, expiration, origin, destination, route length, all that sort of stuff. We'll go price per distance because that would be probably like the best value. We've got a few jobs to choose from. More jobs open up as we level up and get more skills, like transporting fragile cargo or dangerous cargo, as well as upgrading the length of route that we're allowed to drive on and that sort of thing as well. So for now, our options are fairly limited, but we'll see. What do we got? What's the top one? Cambridge to Amsterdam. So we could hop across to Holland and deliver what exactly? I don't know. I don't know where it says. Something like Agro Vista, so something presumably farming related. We could milk. It says it right there. Oh no, Dave, it says it right there in the big yellow letters, you fucking idiot. 15 tons of milk from Cambridge to Amsterdam. 16 tons of carrots from Cambridge to Portsmouth. And 22 tons of cement from Cambridge to Portsmouth as well. We take 24 tons of clothes from Cambridge to Cardiff. That pays us the most in one go, even though the price per distance is not as good as these ones above it. That actually gives us a big heap of cash all in one go. That is... how far is that? It's 296 miles versus... these are considerably less. I feel like sticking within the United Kingdom, to begin with at least, and then we will kind of branch out from there. There's a lot of the Eurotruck world for us to explore, and there will be a lot of the American Truck Sim world for us to explore as well, because I think I will, in this series, interchangeably switch between this and American Truck Simulator. We'll make a company in both games with the same logo and same name and probably the same wacky portrait. And we'll just run it as different branches of the same company, I guess you might say. So I'll switch between the two, although for now we're just gonna see if we can build things up here a bit in Eurotruck before we branch across the pond, so to speak. And you know, like I said last time, I'm still kind of waiting on a bunch of DLC and things like that to come out for American Truck Simulator. So, but anyway, I think we'll do Cardiff. I wouldn't mind driving to Cardiff. I've driven to Cardiff a few times in real life. It'd be interesting to see how it compares, actually. Usually it's surprisingly good in the sim anyway, so... yeah, let's do it. We'll take 24 tons of clothes to Cardiff. DB Schenker, DHL, I don't know which is which there. Like, who are we working for? I'm not really sure. But, We're going to be driving a Mercedes-Benz. Ooh, very nice. Very, very swanky. All right, so let's do it. Trip time is 7 hours, 42 minutes in Eurotruck time. It's amazing, isn't it? 7 hours, 42 minutes to drive that relatively tiny distance. Whereas, I think if you were in America, probably wouldn't take 7 hours to drive that tiny distance, would it? But that's just because European and UK roads, I guess. But anyway, let's do it. So take job. There we go. We'll get thrust onto a loading screen, I'm sure. You might even get a black screen right now. I don't know, because I noticed when I was doing editing together the first video, what happened was when I selected my profile and the game basically froze up while it was loading stuff, what it did is it basically, on the recording, it flashed to my desktop, even though my desktop wasn't actually on the screen. It was really weird. And so, since I figured it'd be a bit weird of you to all sit there looking at my desktop for a good few minutes, I would just give you a black screen instead with a silly message on it. So that's what I did. So hopefully it hasn't happened again, though. Otherwise it means more editing work for me, but whatever. Anyway, we're in the cab now. This is, 24 tons of clothes in that. It's not a very big trailer, is it? But it's, you know, reasonably heavy, I think. Compared to our last load, anyway. Well, alright then. I redid my ProMods definitions file as well, so the interior sounds are a bit louder than they were before. And I lowered the music volume in the menu, because that was a bit crazy loud, so... Alright, I guess we'll get on with this. So let's go down here and have a look at the... Alright, that was a real wild stab in the dark, that was. The way my keyboard's positioned at the minute, I can't actually see the M key. Because the steering wheel's in the way. So I had to basically just guess there. And I got it right, it looks like. So we're going to be leaving Cambridge, heading southbound out through here, down the M11, then around the M25. Yeah, big ring road around London itself. And then down the M4 all the way to this bit I have driven in real life, actually. I might have even driven down here to get here, now that I think about it. But yeah, I've driven down here before. I had an interview, a couple of interviews actually, at Cardiff University. And I once went to an open day there as well. And I've driven through here on my way to other bits of South Wales too on holidays a few times, so... I'm genuinely curious to see if I can spot a few landmarks on the way down there as we get into Cardiff, actually. It could be interesting, but anyway. So that's where we're going to go. So let's get moving, I guess. And let's see if my driving improves much after last time, because last time it was pretty shocking. All right. Remember, Dave, remember what country you're in. We drive on the left! Getting a bit stush. Oh, you bastards. I was just rolling up. Ugh, oh, never mind. I don't know how long this is actually going to take us in game time. Obviously, it's all sped up a bit. You know, as I explained last time, but... Oh yeah, I installed a traffic mod, by the way. I forgot to probably check what part of the load order it was in, but... So hopefully it seems to be working okay. It's not the same traffic mod I mentioned last time that made things completely ridiculous for me. I have new mail, apparently, but it'll be for the bank trying to tempt me into a loan, probably. It's a different traffic mod that basically, the traffic amount changes depending on like the time of day and stuff. So if it's nighttime, there's virtually no traffic. But if it's rush hour, then you get lots. I figured that was actually not a bad idea, really. In theory, anyway. I kind of like that level of realism, at least. Because previously, with the traffic mod I tried before, it was just rush hour all the time. And there was just total gridlock. Didn't matter what time of day it was. It was kind of weird. So... So anyway, we'll see how we get on with this little mod here. I will endeavour, I didn't do it for the previous video, but I will endeavour to put a full load order list. Are those horses or cows in the back of that? I think they are. I'll endeavour to put a big old list along with, you know, in the sorted load order of all my mods. And I'll just copy and paste that across videos and edit it where necessary. Just like I do for Fallout or Skyrim or whatever. Speed cameras. I can't see us going that fast in this thing. We're pretty heavy. I mean, I would have thought 24 tons was pretty heavy. But that's just the trailer. So you can actually listen to the radio in this game. There's like, you can literally, if we go into the escape menu, I'm not going to do it, but you know, in theory, what you can do is you can go into the escape menu. Oh, excuse me, I had lasagna for dinner like about half an hour ago and it is fighting back right now. But yeah, if you you go in the escape menu, there's a radio option and you can actually listen to real world radio. Like, I could literally right now, if I wanted to, tune into BBC Radio 2 while driving my pretend truck in the game, which is actually kind of cool if you ask me. Can I change the, yeah, so it's a little bit less intrusive. There we go, on the left there. If you press F3, it gets rid of all the borders and buttons and things. Speed limit here is 60. We're struggling to beat 36 at the moment though. All right. Still haven't, oh man, I still haven't done my indicator buttons. Oh dude, get this truck out of the way. All right, I know I'm not indicating, I know I'm a bad driver, I'm sorry, they're broken, they're literally broken, there's nothing I can do. It's probably illegal to drive without working indicator lights now that I think about it. It's just something like that anyway. Maybe I'm thinking of a different kind of light. I don't know. I don't drive, guys. I'm sorry. I don't even get lifts that often. Genuinely, just... this is probably really weird, especially to Americans, because all of you drive from, like, age 16 onwards, it seems. But, I don't know anything about cars. I don't drive anywhere. Although, weirdly enough, I enjoy road trips. That's a funny thing. Like, one of the reasons I think I really enjoy this game and other things like Flight Sim and things like that is because I really enjoy travel. And it's ironic considering I don't do much of it these days because I can't afford to, but I really enjoy travel. Some of my genuinely fondest memories... Look at that windsock. Genuinely fondest memories are from all the times my family used to go abroad on sort of road trips, you know, around France. And, you know, just generally on the continent and stuff. And I think one of the reasons I really enjoy... we should think about getting some... topping up the fuel at some point, really. Our employer will cover the fuel costs, so... we don't really have to worry about fuel. We'll see another service station before we reach Cardiff, I should imagine. We'll be fine for now. But, yeah, we used to go on holidays, and we always used to drive, because we were too poor to get planes or, you know, anything like that. You know, maybe sometimes we'd go on the ferry, but obviously you drive your car onto the ferry. And you take it with you. But I used to love it. It was absolutely fantastic. Just, you know, we'd drive for hours and hours and hours. It was like, in terms of driving time, quite often, it was the equivalent of going on, getting on a plane and flying to Singapore or something. Kind of crazy, really, but it was always great fun. And I think one of the things I love about Eurotruck, and it may be the same for a lot of you, frankly, is that it reminds me of those kind of good old days, really. Especially when we actually are driving around like France and Amsterdam and stuff. One of the new DLCs that came out for this game recently was called Vive la France. Vive la France or Vive la France or whatever. It's a DLC that expands France and adds more cities and towns and things like that to drive through. And I'm genuinely looking forward to doing that because it's gonna bring back a bit of nostalgia for me. Queues likely. Well, you never know. Maybe they will be. With this new traffic mod, we also are in the wrong lane completely. Get wrecked, rich guy in rich car back there. I don't know what that was. It looked like a Mercedes Benz or something. Oh dear. You know what? I was gonna just jump into the escape menu there and try and fix the indicator lights, but you know what? Let's roleplay, guys. Let's. I'm saying this entirely tongue-in-cheek, of course, but I'm in all seriousness, actually, when I stop at the next service station to get some fuel, I'll see if I can fix the indicator lights button. Because I need to assign others as well. Now that they've all been unbound by making a new profile, I need to reassign, like, my headlights and all sorts of stuff. So now we're driving a pretty bog basic truck at the minute, but you get other things like engine retarders and things like that on the truck, which you need buttons for, I think, really. So that is something I will need to take care of. A few of them, if I don't have to use it too regularly, I can just use the keyboard commands, which is fine, but sometimes, like, if you want to switch between... Oh, God, I'm in the wrong lane again. I'm a genius. Sometimes if you want to switch between, say, high-beam headlamps and the, you know, regular non-high-beam ones, because the... Believe it or not, it's quite funny, but the oncoming traffic in the other direction over there, they get pissed at you if you, if you drive with the high beams on in their faces, they actually flash their lights at you. It's quite funny. London, the South, Watford. I know that sounds really daft, but we do actually have that on the road signs here in the UK. We'll have signs that say the South or the North. And I know it sounds like something out of Game of Thrones, but genuinely, we do have that. And I really want to get past this guy into the right lane, but it's not going to happen. This dickhead in his... Aston Martin or whatever the fuck that is. It's not Aston Martin, you idiot. That's like... I'm sorry. Objects in the rearview mirror may be more aerodynamic than they appear, okay? All right, fine. Just give me a break. All right, let's swap over now. Genuinely, it looked a lot more sporty in the mirror than it actually did when it went past. God damn it. There's loads of traffic mods you can get for this, and I don't mean like traffic mods as in they change the amount of traffic. I mean ones that add new cars and motorbikes and trailers and things. I might consider getting a few of those installed. I mean, Promods does come with an optional pack that adds a bunch of things like that, I think, which I do have installed, but there's a bunch of others I remember from back when I used to play this ages ago. Might be worth getting. Some that add police cars as well, which is kind of fun. They don't really do anything other than drive around and occasionally have the sirens on and the lights, but... Still cool to have. In American Truck Simulator, the police will actually give you speeding tickets, like if you're speeding and there's a car there and stuff. A police car, I mean, obviously. Oh, shit, hello. Okay, service station. Let's see if we can get in there without smashing into somebody. Oh, thank Christ, I was going to say, like, if he takes that spot on the right there, you bastard. That's the only one I'm allowed to have as a truck. I can't go on the left, so... Guy refueled quickly and he didn't even get out of his car to do it. That's amazing. All right. Engine off. Luckily, I don't have to pay for any of this. There we go. It's full. And also, email. I guess we could check our emails. Brand new Volvo trucks for sale. London truck dealer. Dear sir or madam, we are a certified retailer of Volvo trucks. We offer a wide selection of different configurations and we can also perform customizations to accommodate any special wishes. Please visit our showroom in London. The truck you have always dreamt of might be waiting just behind the door. Best regards, your Volvo truck dealer. Okay. I see. We're a way off buying ourselves a truck, but when we do, I think it probably will be a Volvo. I don't know, I just like Volvos. Stupid communist Volvos, as someone said in the comments. Gotta drive a Peterbilt like Jesus did. we will drive some Peterbilts when we get into American Truck Sim, trust me. Kenworths and Peterbilts for days, just for days. And they are badass trucks, so I'm right with you on that. Okay, let's see, options. Game... Oh, no. Okay, keys and buttons is what we want. Right. Okay, so let's have a look. Parking brake. That's space, apparently. Engine brake is B. I won't worry about that for now. Trailer brake. Retarder increase and decrease. There's a lot of stuff here. Lift slash drop axle. Lots of stuff to do with trucks that I don't actually understand yet, but we'll learn, I'm sure. Ah, okay, here we go with the indicators. All right, so let's... All right, I've assigned both of those. Light modes. That can stay as L, and we'll go high beam headlights. That button. And horn and air horn. I guess we can have, you can be horn and you can be air horn. Light horn? What? Wipers is P, apparently. Okay, good to know. Cruise control, so is C. That could stay as C, that's fine. I think there's... what are we in right now? Mercedes? This probably has cruise control, right? I know the Scania, like the bog basic Scania you get, doesn't have cruise control, which drives me nuts sometimes. Right. Looks like we're done here. Mr. Land Rover, or whatever he is done as well. Let's go. Fuel expenses are covered by your employer, like I said. There you go. And now... I can indicate! Oh my god! Breaking this traffic. Ooh, Mini! Not, it's a new Mini, not one of the old awesome Minis, but still. Alright, here we go. This'll do. Indicator does obviously automatically cut out if you turn enough. But evidently that wasn't quite enough. The scenery in Eurotruck is surprisingly accurate most of the time, I've got to say. The ProMod stuff helps with that, but even so, this look a lot like, I mean, you know, this is pretty much exactly what any English motorway looks like. Right here. They've got it pretty much bang on. I mean, obviously it's not geographically accurate because all the distances and time and stuff are compressed down, but the overall sort of look of it is just pretty much right there. It's got, one of the reasons I like this game is because I love going to the other countries I've never been to before and just sort of looking out the window and seeing what they're like. At the turn quite wide enough there, or possibly it was just a bumpy bit of road. Driving with a big ass trailer on the back is harder than it may appear, I will say that much. Not as hard as reversing the stupid thing, but still. Speed limit here is 60. So let's see if we can get some momentum going and then I'll whack on the cruise control. We're going to be on this road for a little while here. How do I make it? There we go, yeah, I can do the different views. Yeah, we're going to be on the M2, oh, sorry, the M4. For freaking ages, so, yeah. Let's get our speed up and just go for it. Yeah, that'll do. Alright. Cruise control. Alright, sweet. Time to put off the pedal, finally. Take a break, it says. Just done that. The next sign up here says to get a Kit Kat. I'm done. I feel like my position, head position, is really far back right now. Oh god. Yeah, that's a bit better. We should get into this lane here. Is that the same Land Rover from earlier, just there on our left? I'd be surprised if it was. Everybody's going faster than us. We could go faster, I suppose, if we wanted to. Just gotta watch out for the speed cameras. I've managed to clock one of these trucks at about 90, I think. I think it was in either Germany or Holland, and I just got a huge stretch of motorway with very few cars on it, and I just went ham with the accelerator. And I had a lot of downhill to help me as well. And I managed to get going crazy fast. But in good old Britain, with our speed cameras every 20 feet, maybe not such a brilliant idea, because I tell you what, the speeding tickets in this game and stuff do add up after a while. So. Oh, big old wing turbines over there on the left. Can't recall I've ever seen massive power lines hanging that low over a motorway before, but maybe I'm wrong. That does look a little bit strange. Is that on our left making all that noise? It's a freaking coach. Oh god! Nobody saw that. Even the coach is going faster than me. Screw you, coach. Oh, I'm on the inside of the turn now. He's still beating me. Oh dear. Is 5 miles per hour making that much difference, or is just literally everybody speeding right now? Screw it. Let's floor it. See if we can go faster. I mean, I get that perhaps the speed limit for the cars is higher than it is for this truck here, now that I think about it. But not the coach! It's taking quite a bit of effort to get past 55, actually, isn't it? I just can't seem to do it. Oh, here we go. We've got a bit of a downhill slope now, this'll help. Oh yeah, there we go. Doesn't seem to want to be able to manage it. Oh well. Yep, around 55-ish is about as good as we can do on the flat and level, I suppose. Never mind. I'm in 12th gear right now. God, these trucks have like so many gears. It's crazy. I think some of them have like 13 or 14. Now, one of the reasons I like the Volvo is because, if I recall, I think one of the biggest engines in the game, it's one of the most powerful engines in the game, you can put in a Volvo. So that might have something to do with it, but... I kind of want to drive a Volvo with a ridiculously powerful engine in it. Just, I don't know why. Because why not? Because power! Basically. No half measures, you know? If you're gonna truck, you might as well do it with maximum effort. He's got his lights on, apparently. Oh, here we go. There's a police car outside. Don't know if you guys heard it on the video. I'll see when I go to editing it, but... There you go. If you didn't hear the police car on the video, then it means that mission accomplished as far as this mic is concerned. Look at those big fucking cranes. Oh my god. Some guy's playing construction simulator over there, apparently. Cardiff, this way. Hooray. Yeah, it's definitely made a... Oh, God. Nearly shit myself there because I was thinking, wait a minute, do I have to turn off here? But no, we don't. We're good. It's made a difference. I enabled the option in the Promods definitions thing file. I boosted the interior audio, like when you're in the cab here, by like 8 times the normal level, and it's definitely made a difference. Like, I can actually hear the engine and then the traffic and stuff now, as opposed to before where it was just crazy quiet for some reason. Yeah, well, anyway, I'm looking forward to doing some trips on the continent. I'd like to do one up to Scotland, somewhere up there. The scenery, from what I can remember, up in Scotland in Eurotruck is just absolutely gorgeous. And I'm pretty sure if you drive past Loch Ness, you can actually see the Loch Ness monster, which is good for a laugh. But ages ago, I did a Twitch stream of Eurotruck. And, oh god, I'm actually breaking the speed limit right now. GG. I just noticed all the traffic was moving slower than me. I was like, hang on a second. Oh yeah, it's this big-ass bridge. Yeah, I remember this from driving to Wales. I almost said France there. No, I remember this from driving to Wales, big time. I forget what it's called, but I just remember there being a big-ass bridge on the way to Wales. Cruise control back on. There we go. Anyway, yeah, I'm looking forward to doing some trips to France in Eurotruck and Scotland. But yeah, anyway, as I was saying, there was this a stream I did where we went to Norway, and that was where we had the infamous "Welcome to Wales" and something Creoso something Simru, which I think is pronounced Cymru, but for some weird reason, because Welsh, what a weird language, honestly. If you think it's bad, like, I once heard someone say that as a general rule, when you visit England, none of the place names are pronounced the way they're spelled. And if you think, well, my two cents is, if you think that's bad in England, you should see Wales. It's not even a case of pronunciation, it's a case of they use an L and they pronounce it as a C. Or possibly the way around, I don't even remember. It's completely bonkers. All right, I need to try and sneak past these fellas. Ooh. Whee! Okay. So, yeah. What does that say? I can't read it from here. I think there's a zoom button in this game, you know? I just don't remember what it is. Alright, here we go. Cardiff is this way. It doesn't look like we're going to take the M4 right into the centre, which is a bit of a shame, which means we'll probably miss what I was looking for, which is the Cardiff City Hospital, which is this big-ass building that is on your right, over there when you're driving down that motorway. And I was kind of curious to see if they'd actually managed to put it in here. But, it doesn't look like we'll get there. Oh well. We're going to get a fine view now, aren't we? Look at this. Wilnet Transport. Never heard of him. Oh, we've got the cat's eyes out on the road. Nice. I heard. Okay, right. I have no idea if this is true. In America, your equivalent of cat's eyes, if you drive over them, they break. Is that true? Because our ones here in the UK, if you drive over them, it cleans the lens. Like, it goes bump down into the ground when the tire goes over it, and it actually, in so doing, it cleans the lens. Is that true? Do the ones in America break if you drive over them? Because if so, that's kind of funny. In a sense of, like, why on earth did you design it like that? Object that needs to go on the road, the brakes, you know, brakes when it gets run over. That just doesn't make any sense. Or whatever. It's odd how I'm getting God rays through the sun visor there, I guess. That looks a bit strange. I don't like the sun visor anyway. I'd rather get rid of it. Well, we're on the back roads now. This is where this game gets really fun, to be honest with you. It's when you're on the smaller roads. Enjoying a bit of the countryside or some of the cities and stuff like that. That's where the fun is. Especially if you go to Norway, which is... I keep getting sidetracked, but yeah, it's when we did that stream a while ago and we went to Norway and we had the big toll booth incident. And we also went to Sweden as well. But the scenery there was just incredible, especially once you're off the motorways. It was crazy. Did you know in Norway they have roundabouts, right? But they don't just have roundabouts, like regular roundabouts here. They have underground roundabouts. They have, you know, like roads that go under huge tunnels under mountains, right? And under those mountains, on these roads, they have roundabouts. It's crazy. Oh, you'll notice once now we're in Wales, by the way, half the signs are going to have Welsh written on them as well as English. Which is why it says off or araf. Whatever that is, in addition to slow written on the ground there. Let's see, which one was my lights? That's the horn. No air horn, apparently. Oh, I just need to press L, don't I? And then the one on my wheel, that switches between high beams and not high beams. Alright, we're getting into Cardiff itself now, finally. Cardiff discovered. Wonderful. And pedestrians, my god. I don't remember those from when I last played this. That's crazy. I don't know which position is the high beams. Whatever. If we see angry cars flashing their headlights, then we'll know. A bit bright for that, really, though. I feel like I don't even need them on at all. Whoa, there we go. That's put the lights on. I think I just put some of the external LEDs on. Yeah, that's what happens. You cycle through it three times. Look. Oops. Right, that's definitely the high beams. Mystery solved. Yeah, we don't need that on. That is a nice meaty indicator sound, if I do say so myself. Alright, we're nearly there. Just another right turn and we'll be at DHL's, I don't know, warehouse, something. Wherever it is, we're taking these clothes. It's quite a surprisingly gorgeous game, to be fair, this, actually. I mean, it's not going to win any awards for graphical fidelity, but at the same time, it's no slouch. It has its moments where it looks goddamn gorgeous. It's a shame I didn't start this series a bit sooner, because there's some fantastic mods you can get out there for this game, and what the... Oh, yeah? Alright. This whole situation here with the traffic seems a little bit weird, but... But anyway, you can get some incredible mods for this that retexture basically the entire world to match, like, autumn or winter or, like, early winter. It looks really good. I'm wondering if I should actually switch to the early sort of soft winter preset, because outside my window, certainly right now, the trees do not look this green yet. But the heavy winter ones where you actually get snow everywhere, and that is seriously cool. And it's a shame we didn't start the series in the winter, because we could have taken advantage of that, but never mind. Because, I mean, come on, who doesn't love a bit of ice road truckers, right? Alright, so this is going to be a little more interesting than our previous attempts at reversing. I am going to be a scrub and go on the external view as before. You know, we're still learning. I'm still learning this trucking business, so... Now, the key thing to remember, I've been told here, is to think of yourself as literally just pushing a box around and maneuver the truck... with that in mind. Think of the truck as a lever or something, or a stick on a pole or whatever, and you're pushing the box around using it. And once you think of it that way, it doesn't become quite as ridiculously difficult. I guess it works. Oh, that's not too bad. How's the game gonna let it? There we go. Yeah, it's gonna accept it. Sweet. Job well done. Decoupling. We did it! Good work. Clothes delivered from Cambridge to Cardiff. 303 miles, 7 hours and 2 minutes of Eurotruck time and a bunch of fuel. Damage penalty, so we did hit something at some point. We lost 42 experience and £431 for that. Wow. Okay, fine. Note to self, try not to hit things. Alright, sweet. And we've leveled up, I think. Because we were level 0. Yeah, here we go. Alright, so, what have we got? ADR training. The transportation of dangerous goods demands well-trained professionals. Well, that rules me out then, doesn't it? It's your hard-earned experience to acquire the following ADR certificates and substantially increase your income. Explosives, such as dynamite, fireworks, or ammunition. Gases. Flammable gases, for example, acetylene or hydrogen. Good grief. Look at all this stuff. Woohoo! All disasters in the making with me at the helm. Long distance. This is what I am interested in. That might be what I get, honestly. Eco-driving. That reduces fuel usage. That's not a priority for us, I don't think, at the moment, really, because we don't actually pay for our fuel at the moment. Until we get our own truck, it's not really a factor at all. So what else we got? High-value cargo. All cargo is valuable, but some loads are more valuable than others. Companies trust only proven experts to carry out these kind of deliveries. Fragile cargo, again. Recipe for disaster. Glass electronics or delicate machinery. Just-in-time delivery. Sometimes companies need to deliver something important quickly, so they call for a just-in-time job. Such work puts more stress on the driver. The delivery window is tighter, but the compensation eases your level of discomfort. A new rank in the skill will result in important deliveries unlocked. 3% higher reward for finishing an important delivery. 20% experience bonus for finishing an important delivery. Okay. See, that I can see myself doing, because I'm a bit of a champion at breaking speed limits by accident. So whatever happens, we're probably going to get there pretty quick. You just don't have as much liberty to sort of go rest at a rest, you know, like a service station or something like that. I think for now, I'm going to grab long distance. And I will think about just-in-time delivery after that. But yeah. Just being able to drive longer and more interesting places, essentially. That's the key thing for me at the moment, at least. All right. Apply. Cool. Well, there we go. Our first proper job done, not really counting the tutorial job, which was tiny and stupid and worthless. That's our first actual proper job done. Cambridge to Cardiff, sweet. And we delivered some clothes and we got paid a bunch of money. We've now got 9.6 grand in the bank, which is still pitifully little. However, it's something. So, yeah. So game time is Monday, so nearly 8 o'clock. So it looks like the next job we do might be a night, which should, I guess, be cool. Bit of a night journey, which, if the traffic mod does its job, means we'll have very empty roads and no traffic jams to worry about, which would be pretty cool. So anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thanks very much. I will catch you next time, and in the meantime, have fun and keep on trucking, I guess. Oh, shit. You know what? I might just call the series Keep on Trucking. I'll have to, like, Google and make sure nobody else has already taken that or something, but yeah, that'd be a nice catchy name. That might work. All right, either way, folks, that was really good fun, and I will see you for the next video whenever that happens to be, since you guys definitely seem to want more of this. All right, that's it, folks. Toodles.